start, we start.
So I remember it like it was just yesterday. It was like a warm summer morning. I just woke up. It was a very crazy night because, like, I couldn't remember. But anyways, I woke up and I saw to my left, and I saw the look of my friend's face, and I thought he was dead, but he was just dead asleep. And then after looking to my right, I was looking for my other friend. I was like, I wonder why he's not here. So I'm like, all right, I gotta go to the bathroom. So I start walking to the bathroom. And as I'm going to the bathroom, I hear a snoring from like a near. And I kind of open up the curtains to the bathroom, a tub, and I see him knocked out in the tub. And I'm like, what happened last night? So I kind of woke him up and asked him a couple questions. I was like, dude, what happened last night? He's like, well, after the party, we Ubered home. And we just kind of stayed here. And I was like, all right, just forget about it. It happened last night. Whatever, let's go on with our day. So as we're going on with our day, we're like, all right, we don't want to waste our day. And so as we like didn't want to waste our day, we're like, let's go to the gym and go hit some chest, you know? It was International Chest Day, and we're like, all right, we're going to go hit some chest. So as we drove off to the gym, we're at the gym, we're just doing our thing, you know, on the bench, maybe some incline. And then after going to the gym, we were so hungry from like working out and from the party last night, so we went to go eat breakfast. As I'm standing in the line eating breakfast, I'm over here saying, dang, I want a burrito. Like, a burrito sounds really good. So I order a burrito, and as I'm waiting for my burrito, this waitress brings me out like a big old baby, like wrapped in a thing, like wrapped in a wrapper, and I'm like, dang, this burrito looks bomb. And all my friends are like, damn, that burrito looks bomb. I was like, well, go buy one, because I'm not sharing. Anyways, after I'm eating this burrito, I'm like, oh, I'm so full. All right, let's go home and take a nap. So I drove home, took a nap, and we woke up around midday. And I was like, all right, cool. Like, what are we going to do for the rest of the day? And my friends were all contemplating on what to do. And we're like, all right, let's drive out to Inglewood and have some dinner. So we're like, all right. We drove out to Inglewood. As we reached the restaurant, we're all eating, you know. We're all just getting fat, eating wings at B-Dubs at Inglewood because, like, we're just done like that. And so as, like, we're eating, watching the game, watching Monday Night Football, we're like, all right, cool. Like, you know, like, we're chilling. All right, let's leave. Let's go back home. It's around 11 o'clock at night. And as we're walking home, the car's two blocks away because it's Inglewood, you know. There's never parking there. And we're walking. As we approach this alley, we see a dark shadow approach us from the right. And we're like, all right, like, what's happening, you know? And this guy comes up with us with a gun. He's like, you know what? Give me your wallets. And I'm like, you know what? You need to relax. Like, all right, here's my wallet. But I just got 3K in my bank account. I mean, in my head, I'm like, why would I just tell him I have 3K in my bank account? He probably needs that money. And so anyways, I'm like, I got 3K. I don't really want to give it to you, but like, I really don't want to die today. Like, here you go. And the guy's like, all right, what about your friend's wallets? And my friend comes up from behind me, and he has a gun too. And he's like, you know what? Give him his wallet back. And I'm like, dude, where'd you get the gun? And he's like, I just got it from the pawn shop. And I was like, oh my God, like, we're all about to die. Like, he's about to shoot someone. I'm going to get arrested. I'm going to be part of this crime. Like, I'm like, all right, if you get shot, like, I'm not a part of this, right? My friend's like, what are you saying? I'm getting your money back. And I'm like, all right, you know what? It's fine. All right. The guy kind of saw, like, the gun and thought, like, we weren't playing. So he kind of threw my wallet back and kind of took off. And then as my friend, like, looked at me, he started laughing. I was like, what's so funny? He starts shooting the gun and bubbles come out. And I was like, oh my God. He's like, I told you I got it at the pawn shop. He's like, you think I'm old enough to get this at the pawn, like a gun at the pawn shop? I'm like, all right, whatever. And his buddy saw that we shot the gun and it was shooting bubbles. So he comes back. And I was like, you know what? That's a fake gun. Now give me your wallets again and you too. And I'm like, oh my God, we're all gonna die. And my buddy from behind comes up and he's like, all right, I'm not playing anymore. And he shoots off a real gun and I'm like, oh my God, the guy dropped his wallets. The like look on his face was priceless. And I'm like, we're all screwed. So the guy, I pretty much picked up my wallet and we booked it to my car. And I'm all full. I'm like, got a nasty cramp on my side. And I'm like, I don't think I'm gonna make it, guys. Here, take my keys. And then as we drove off, like we eventually got to the car, and as we drove off, we see the cops, and this guy's running for his life away from the police car, and I'm all thinking to myself, dang, that could have been us. I was like, dang, like, what if that was us? I was like, that's insane. But that was my story, guys.